Step one, you say we need to talk. He walks, you say sit down, it's just talk. Smiles politely.
Francisco de Goya was born in Spain in 1746. At age 14, Goya became a painter's apprentice. In 1765, he began to work with the Royal Tapestry Workshop. Over the course of 5 years, many of his tapestries were used to decorate the stone walls in the castles of the Spanish monarchs. The monarchs took notice of these tapestries and commissioned him to paint their portraits. Goya was known for his rather plain portrayals of the king and his royal family. Many would call them unflattering and harsh, but they were also remarkable. One of his more famous paintings of royals is the family of Charles IV. In 1792, Goya contracted a high fever and was left deaf. He became very withdrawn and introspective. During this time, he sketched a series of etchings that were published under the title Caprichos, or Deceitful Things. It was at this time his style began to change and become darker and sketchier. Spain soon became embroiled in war, which led to one of Goya's most political and powerful works, The 3rd of May. By 1816, Goya was no longer a painter to the king after he lost favor with the court. He became very reclusive and didn't emerge from his house. On the inside of his walls, Goya painted his last and darkest paintings, known as the Black Paintings. He painted the images that came from the deepest, darkest depths of his mind. His visions of monsters, witches, and giants adorned the walls of his house. Goya left Spain in 1812 to settle in Bordeaux. He returned to Spain briefly in 1826, but soon returned to Bordeaux in ill health. He died in 1828 at the age of 82.